Welcome friends to Unstop Java Solutions. I am Snehasis and today I am going to explain you about the access specifiers in Java. Okay. So in Java there are three access specifiers: private, public and protected. Okay. And also there is default access specifier. Default means nothing, means you are not specifying anything as access specifier. Okay. So I'll show you how they are work in Java. Okay, so in my previous video I show you the package. Okay, so now to explain these access specifier, I have to create package. Okay, so I am going to Eclipse and here I am creating two packages. Suppose giving the name as my pack one, okay, or package, my package one, okay, and keeping another name, creating another one, that my package two, giving the name as my package two. So by convention you can give the package name as means first lettered in small. Okay, so you can give capital as well, but by convention you can, it will be good to, if you means maintain the Java convention, so by convention package name should be in small. Okay, so here I am creating one class, new class, and giving the class name as, class name would be public, and giving the name as suppose access specifier demo. Okay, creating main method. Okay, access specifier demo, and inside this package I am creating one class test one class. Okay, and in this test one I am creating few methods. Okay, with those access specifiers, suppose I am giving the name as suppose public void, giving the name public display, and I am printing something. Public display method. Display method. Okay. So save it. So this is my public method. Similarly, I am creating private, public, then private display, and giving the same name here as well, public, private, then creating another one is protected. Okay, giving the same name here, protected display, and here instead of public giving the protected display method. Okay, and another one is default. Means I will not write any access specifier here, so instead of void, this is default display. Here also default display method. Okay, so this is inside my package one. Okay, and here I am creating test one, here I am creating another one. Inside this package I am creating suppose test two. Okay, test two, in creating main method as well. Okay. So now inside this test 2, I am creating object of test 1. Okay. Test 1 T1 equal to new test 1. Okay. So I am creating the test 1 object, and test 1 for test 1 it is my package 1, so I have to import that my package 1 dot test 1. Okay. Now if I call T1 dot okay public display, okay, so this will work. So if I run this code, so it will, here you can see public display method. So I public method I can call from another package with another method, another class. Okay, but here you cannot call protected or private or default, nothing you can call from other. So it's clear that only public member you can call from any other package with any other, from any other classes. Okay, so public method you can call. So all the methods inside this, and here I already created access specifier demo.java. So inside this method, inside this class, I am creating this test object. Okay, test t1 equal to new. So these two class are in the same package. Okay, access specifier demo and test one. So for that, if you create the object, you don't have to import that package because both are in the same packages. Okay, so that's why you don't have to import anything. Now if you call t1 dot default display, so you can call it. If you call t1 dot protected display, that also you can call. And if you run this method, so here you can see default display method, protected display method, you can access from here. But if you try to private, then you cannot call the private method. So private method you cannot access outside the class. Okay, so it's clear that protected and default you can call any other class within the same package. Okay, and from test one, if you create main method here, and if you create the object of the test one, so here you can call all the methods. So this is the first one, t1 dot private, also here you can call, and here t1 dot default. Default is already there, public. Okay, and here also means from access specifier public you also can call here. Public you can call from anywhere. T1 dot public display. Okay, so public you can call from anywhere. So if you execute it, so here you can see you can call the default display. Okay. Protected display method and public display method. So default, protected and public you can access from the same package, within the same package, from any other classes. Okay, from the same package and same classes you can access everything, means public, protected, okay, public, protected, default and private. All members or access specifier you can call from the same package, same class. Okay, but same package, different class. Okay, except private you can call everything, means default, protected and public. But different package, different class, you can only access the public method. Okay, so these are the access specifiers in Java. Okay, so these are the means basically this is the mechanism using the access specifier. This is the one mechanism in Java that restrict the access of your member, data member. Okay, data member or member function, whatever. So you can restrict your access. So using the access specifier, you can control or restrict your access, means from which class or which package or from where you can access those methods or member data members. Okay, so that you can restrict. Okay, so hope it's clear. So there is four access specifiers: private, public, protected, and default. If you nothing mentioned as a access specifier, then it's treated as a default. Okay, so this is the concept of the access specifiers in Java. Okay, so hope it's you can understand. So if you like my videos, you can share with your friends and also subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon so that once I upload the next video, you will get the notification. And in description box, you can see my channel link is there, so you can go there and watch the relevant videos related to Java. Okay, so Code Java, Advanced Java, and also web application. Every means I am uploading all the videos related to this topic, so you can go there and watch whatever required for you. Thanks for watching this video.